Number 3. Look at your competitor's name for inspiration. You don't have to copy anyone, but looking at your competitor's brand name can remove your mind blocks and give you some more creative ideas. Do Airtel and Aircel sound similar to you? Well, you get the idea. Number 4. Consider different languages. Try to find your brand name in different languages. It might not be available in English and registered to someone else, but it might be available in other languages and can be usable for you. So try to find out the name you are thinking in different languages. It might be available and you may be able to use them for your own business. Even if not, you can also combine two or more different languages to come up with a name which will be unique and meaningful at the same time. But please remember that if your brand name is meaningful, then it loses its bop potential. We will talk more about it later or in the next episode. Number 5. Combine words. You can also combine two or more different words to make a new one. There is a higher possibility that the name would be a unique one and will be available to use. Like for an example, Pinterest. It is clear that the name is a combination of two different words, pin and interest. Similarly, there are a lot of examples out there, but right now I can only think of this one. If you are able to think some more examples like this, please leave a comment if possible wherever you are listening to this podcast.